Bonjour à toutes et à tous. C'est un grand plaisir de participer à cette édition de la Conférence de Montréal dédiée à une économie plus verte et plus juste. The world is changing fast. We are in a climate emergency evidenced by climate change that is affecting every inhabited region across the globe. This summer alone, we witnessed devastating heat waves in North America, forest fires in BC and Ontario, and horrific flooding in parts of China, Europe, and most recently in parts of the US. In early August, and as a key input for COP26 later this year, the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change published the first part of its sixth assessment report, Code Red, dedicated to the physical science basis of climate change. Its conclusions are both clear-cut and frightening. The latest research confirms the severity of climate change, its unequivocal attribution to human activities, and the necessity to reduce greenhouse gas emissions deeply to avoid further worsening after mid-century. The consensus among the scientific community is that we collectively need to limit temperature rises to a maximum 1.5 degrees Celsius above pre-industrial levels by 2100 to protect our planet. There is no plan B, as there's no planet B. The evidence of climate change is also driving a profound reassessment of risk, which is fostering rapid capital reallocation. A growing percentage of investors and lenders now recognize that climate risk is a financial risk and are integrating ESG criteria into their respective investment and financing portfolios to lower overall risks, as well as to benefit from the opportunities that sustainable and responsible investment business performance brings. In this context, we at BNP Paribas want to continue to be best positioned to accompany our clients. In April of this year, BNP Paribas joined as a founding member the UN-convened Net Zero Banking Alliance, a coalition of bank signatories with a common commitment to transition their lending portfolios and make them compatible with a maximum temperature rise of 1.5 degrees Celsius above pre-industrial levels by 2100. What has happened in the past year is a real shift from advocacy on sustainability and individual voluntary action to public disclosure and collective commitments. What is probably even more important is that we made this commitment as part of a large group of banks, now 55, covering $37 trillion USD in assets, and also in conjunction with similar net zero alliances of investors and asset owners. The collective nature of the net zero commitment alliances will both increase the magnitude and accelerate the speed of megatrends. It will pose substantial challenges, such as transition risk, which for some sectors mean facing big shifts in asset values or higher cost of doing business. At BNP Paribas, we firmly believe that sustainable and equitable growth calls for collective actions, partnerships, and coalitions in close collaboration with our clients. We have to co-invent a better future together. It is now my pleasure to introduce the panel discussion on investing in net zero, which will tackle important questions such as, what does investing in net zero really mean? What investors should do in order to make a critical impact towards net zero? And which sectors should be targeted for investment? Pleased to welcome our esteemed speakers, Asoka Werman, Chairman and CEO at DWS, Mark Versi, CEO of Aviva Investors, Afsane Beschloss, CEO Rock Creek, and Amy Hepburn, CEO, Investor Leadership Network. The panel will be moderated by Sonali Basake, finance reporter at Bloomberg News. With that, Sonali, over to you.